So what is factor analysis? So you already given the input, just I'm throwing some kind of small input related to factor analysis. See this case, this is here our example. I'm using this image. See here, there is a variable of data. So suppose I'm measuring something, some questions I'm giving to you or some scales I'm giving you, the scale consists of 9 items. So normally when you do for the any kind of item analysis or checking for analysis, we have to treat each question as a variable. Each question as a variable. So in the case of each question as a variable, so Sweta Singh, I come from because we move to the next level. So in the end, I will try to explain the Anpo of this way. Okay. In the factor analysis, normally when we look on for doing any analysis, we may take consideration each question as a variable. So we have the 9 variables. Instead of going with the 9 variables, I'm going to reduce the 9 variables into 3 variables. So normally this variable, we may use the word latent variable. So do you know what is the latent variable? So hopefully the tomorrow you may understand what is a latent variable. This is called observed variable, which are things you are observing. So you are observing the 9 variables. From the observing 9 variables, you are going to make it a 3 factors. That 3 factors you are not measuring. But from the observed measure, I am generating a 3 unmeasurable factors or unmeasurable component. Therefore, it's called as a latent. The people are using the word. Therefore, they're using the word underlying factors. What it means, the first 3 questions, it may come under the factor of numerical IQ. It's nothing but a component. That people, some people may use the word factor or component. So I'm going to use as a factor. You can think as a component. Now, the question 4, question 5, question 6 may come under the second component, that is called spatial IQ or second factor. The last 3 is come under the verbal IQ. So the main reason to using the factor analysis to reduce the large number of variables. The main important things, instead of going with 9 times of calculations, so if I want to do the analysis, I have to do the 9 analysis. Instead of that, I'm going to compile, I'm going to be make it some kind of groupism in the 9 questions into some kind of components. Then finally, I'm going to check only the 3 components results. Okay, that is called as factor analysis. The main reason to use it, reduce a large number of variable into fewer number of factors. This is the main. So we are converting the 9 questions to 3. Then the basic assumptions of the factor analysis that collections of observed variable. What is the observed variable? Any idea? So in this case, what is my observed variable? In this example, anyone can highlight what is the observed variable?
Question 1 to question 9.
Question
1 to question 9.
Exactly. So I am observing this only. I am giving the question to all of you. So just I'm telling the example. I am giving you one questionnaire. That question consists of the 9 items. Or I'm giving to one scale. The scales consist of the 9 items. So each items we may treat it as a variable. This is called observe. I'm observing from you, and you are my sample. I'm observing this much of variables. But these are the set of underlining, because some of the variables, some of the questions, it may collinearity, it may have some kind of close call, what is the correlation between the other items. So what did happen? Exactly, mean actually, I'm talking about the dimension only. So the factors, I'm using the term, you can think as the components only. The people, some of the people are having confusion with factor and components, both us look like the same. Okay, so some in the education point of view, we are using the term as a components. Okay, the same components only this one, numerical Q, IQ, spatial Q and all. So here, what did happen? The collection of observed variable, there are set of underlying variable. What did happen? There's a three variable, 1, 2, 3, there is a close relationship with the 3. Due to that only, I'm making, that's called multicollinearity. From the multicollinearity, I'm going to generate a new variable that is called numerical IQ as a latent variable. It's an I'm not seeing directly, but from the 3 things I'm going to compile as a, I'm going to compile as a numerical IQ. In this example, you can easily understand. See it down. There's a 3 variable I'm measuring to you: income, education, occupation, and more than that I'm observing. But the 3 variable, it's having this some close, what is the relationship? Income, education, occupation. So instead of going to 3 measurement, I'm going to convert it to a single factor. What is the factor I'm using? Socio-economic factors. instead of going with income, education, and occupation, instead of going with the three different variables, I'm comparing the three variables in a single components as a socioeconomic factor. This is called factor analysis. Okay, so that is why I'm putting like this. So the observed variable, we can go with this kind of underlying variable called as a small factor. So this underlying variable having some kind of interrelationship between each other. So the each three items having the relationship. That is why it's make compulsory some kind of multicollinearity. That's why we are making a some kind of components. Then the variable IQ, the last three is comes having some kind of close relationship. That's why we compile into a verbal IQ. So this is called factor analysis. Then what is the reason we can go with the factor analysis? These are the objectives. One is for reduce the number of variables. Instead of going with the 30 variable, 30 items, you can compile, you can put it in some kind of components. You can go with only the 5 components based, right? Then examine the structure relation between the variable. Even we can check the unidimensional. That's why I told multicollinearity. Then unidimensionality. So unidimensional in the sense, nothing but the factor, the components. Then evaluate the construct. Even some people are using to construct, evaluate the construct validity with the use of this kind of factor analysis. Then address the multicollinearity. I already mentioned, use develop a theoretical construct. Even some other people using these techniques for the developing the tool. Normally the factor analysis, there's two types. So you are already highlight that one is called confirmative factor analysis. Then other one is called exploratory factor analysis. This is, you have to be get the correct meaning. Otherwise you may always confusing, it may arise. What is the exploratory? Normally what is the explore? You can explore, suppose you are going a new area. So what did happen? You can explore the places, which are the places you are going, you are just to go and explore. You are not familiar with this place, that's why you are going to explore. You already know this place, you don't need to be explored, no? So you already know that what is, where is the particular shop is there, where is the person may sit, the particular cabin. You go and approach them, that is called confirmation. You already knows where that particular thing is there, we can easily to approach. If you are not knowing anything, you can go for explore. You have to be explore the different parts and then explore where it's there, what are things to become involved in this. That is called exploration. Normally, exploration, we may use the term say heuristic. So this is like a heuristic method. The exploratory method is like a heuristic method. But when we can use the exploratory method, for example, you are going to develop one theory, tool. But that tool basic theory is not having any theories, that even the theories also not focusing any kind of dimension. They're not talking about the factors, dimension, about the particular theory. So it means that you don't have any idea about what structure of your data, how many dimensions you are going to make. You are so blind. You are making making some kind of tool, but the tool variable, you are so blindly. So you don't have any kind of previous studies is not talking about the factors or dimension, then you can go with the exploratory. And the main thing is not based on any prior theory. It's not main on any prior theory. For that only we are using the principal component analysis, right? So that is the part of the exploratory factor analysis. That's called principal component analysis. That things I will talk one by one. In the case of confirmative factor analysis, suppose I'm going to develop one personality inventory or personality scale. Okay. Normally, I know that we have to divide the people two ways, introvert and extrovert. So one person's one theory also spoken is the ambivert. Therefore, what I'm going to do, I'm going to develop my statement, and I'm going to my tool with the three dimension. I'm already having the idea. I'm having the 50 statements. Suppose the 50 statements is measuring the personality of the people. But the 50 statement, the 50 items or 50 variables, I'm going to compile into three factors. What are the factors? Introvert, extrovert, as well as ambivert. This theory background we already know. Therefore, I'm going to apply the confirmative factor. If you know any theoretical background, that theoretical background is already specified that this much of dimension is there, this much of factor is there for this particular variable, then you can adopt that particular component. If you're adopting that particular number of component, then you can go with confirmative. That is why I'm using the term basic pre-established theory. If already the theoretical background is there, you can adopt the confirmative factor analysis. If it's not there, you can go with the exploratory. Okay, so normally, that's supposed to factor analysis should be used with tools like rating scale, checklist, And not with that. Normally, we are not using your achievement. No, only for the main for the Likert scale. That kind of scale based, we can go with this kind of factor analysis. Even the personality inventory, other than the achievement. So achievement is not what is it? No need to divide the commonness. Instead of that, only we are checking the objectives. We know the that education. So we know the SAO and GAO. Some specific instruction objectives, general instruction objectives, knowledge, understanding, application analysis. So normally we are checking that one based on that components only, not in this kind of components. I hope you are getting. Normally the achievement test we are checking with that kind of, what is this blueprint? The blueprint only we are using for that. But in the case of what is the rating scale, inventory, we can develop this kind of, we can use this kind of factor analysis. Yes, even the knowledge inventory is not introduced. So we can check the knowledge inventory, we can use this one. Like, I hope now you understand. If you have any theoretical background, the theoretical background is showing this much of competence is talking about this particular variable in the sense, so you can go with confirmative factor analysis. But there is no theoretical background. Even the theoretical background is not highlighting the number of components, then you can go for the exploratory factor analysis. This is only the two terms. Explore it in the sense, the statistically it may generating number of factors, but confirmatory, suppose I like to go with only three factors, you can fix three. The if you are fixing any components, I need only three components, that is called confirmatory. You fix that, I need only three components based on the theoretical input, then you can go for confirmative factor analysis. The same thing only discussing, these are the assumption we have to satisfy before going for the factor analysis. Only things, no outliers, then adequate sample size. For checking the adequate sample size, we are using the test is called KMO test. Minimum 300 sample size is needed for adopting a factor analysis. Then assumption three, no perfect multicollinearity. So collinearity is Nick Morton. I already mentioned that multicollinearity is good, but perfect multicollinearity is not good. Perfect in the sense like, you know, the perfect means the straight line. Normally in the case of the correlation, we are using the term plus one is called perfect positive, minus one is called perfect negative. That kind of collinearity is not needed. So we need multicollinearity, but not any perfect. Then homoscedasticity. So yesterday I also started talking about what is homoscedasticity. There I'm showing with the example also. It means what is the beach factor analysis, which based on the linear assumption only. Then one more thing, our variable, that is why the people are asking the questions whether we can go with rating scale. So even although the ordinal scales are very frequently used for factor analysis approach, so most of the people for doing a factor analysis only for this kind of 5-point scale, 7-point scale, for that they are using. Yes, now this is called linear, this is called homoscedasticity. Even yesterday also in the regression also we had to look at this one. What is homoscedasticity in the sense? Our data may scatter like this one. It not be narrow in one part. See this case, that all the data is narrowing in one area. So this kind of, it's called as a heteroscedasticity. If the data is like this, we could not be go for this kind of factor analysis. Our data, it may be disposed like this. It like, this is called homoscedasticity. No outliers. What is the outlier? See this case, what is this relationship? What is the relationship? Any idea? What is this? What is the relationship?
Whether it's a first one is
positive,
second is negative.
Second is negative.
So see here, all the data is scattered here only. The data is scattered here only. Here also there's data scattered here. But only one variable, one data is scattered there. So we have to remove this one because this factor, this data also may influencing our entire factor analysis. We have to avoid the this kind of outer layer also. Because I already mentioned the assumption, the first assumption is called no outliers. We have to cross check it. Then there's a two steps. So main thing for doing a factor analysis, we need to go with the two steps. One is called factor extraction. Other one is called factor rotation. The first thing, factor extraction. What is it? Any idea about what is by extract? What is by extract? Extracting means you are going to generate your factors. Okay, you are going to extract the factors from your, for example, you have the 35 statement. You are going to extract the 32 statement into 4 factors. That is called extraction. In the extraction only, we are using the two techniques. One is called confirmative, other one is called, what is the other one is called? Exploratory. So exploratory factor analysis, in which stage you can use it? In the which stage? Factor extraction. After selecting the factor, you can go with factor rotation. In the factor rotation, a lot of methods are there. One is called Verimax and oblique method. That method I may focus in the example. Then the type of extractions is talking about this much of method, but normally we are using the principal component, so we can use the principal component. Even some people is using a maximum likelihood method. Maximum likelihood method, the results may come with chi square format. The chi square way. Let's say excellent sound. Yes. Then other one is called common factor analysis. For common factor analysis, we can depends on the structural equation modeling. So I can define one by one. Principal component analysis, how it may happen in the sense, it may comes like a maximum variance to minimum variance. That's order may be there. So whenever you do the principal component analysis, that eigenvalue is come from the highest to, the eigenvalue is nothing but the variances of the each factors. It may comes to the maximum to minimum. So that order it may following the principal component analysis. But in the case of common factor analysis, we are taking the common variance put in the factors. So normally we can use this same. In the case of image factoring, it is, we may check based on the correlation matrix. Normally we use the term as a OLS. Then other one is called maximum likelihood. Correlation matrix, but is for maximum likelihood method to factor. The answers may come with the chi-square format. Even the other methods are also there, like alpha factoring method, weight square is another regression method. But generally, we are using the principal component only, so you can adopt this one only. Then the factor extraction, this only I'm talking, the factor extraction having this much of method. Then the next one is called factor rotation. The factor rotation, basically, the two types are there. One is called orthogonal rotation, other one is called oblique. So this is, you have to see, the orthogonal, some people already put, allows no correlation assumed exactly. Arnob is correct. So orthogonal rotation assumes factors are independent or uncorrelated. If the factors are independent to each other, uncorrelated to each other, you can go for the orthogonal rotations. Oblique rotations means if that, it means that independent to each other, the factors are dependent to each other. It's, what is this? It's correlated in the sense, so that's why I put the word factors are not independent or correlated in the sense, you can go with the oblique. So don't forget, there's a general thing, orthogonal for the uncorrelated, oblique for the correlated. For example, I'm dividing the factors into three, introvert, extrovert, and ambivert. Kindly tell these three kind of factors, whether we can go with orthogonal or oblique. Otherwise, I go with the two factors only, introvert and extrovert.
Orthogonal.
Why is orthogonal? Any idea? Why is orthogonal? We are going to adopt. Because the introvert
behavior is different.
Introvert behavior is different. Extrovert behavior is totally different. Therefore, we can go with orthogonal. So, very good. So, yes. Now, this was in the orthogonal, we have the different methods called Verimax rotation. So in this case, how the Verimax rotation happened, so these are things, once you read the theoretical input only, you can understand. So the Verimax, normally this is called unrotated. This is X and Y, you know, it is called unrotated factor flat. Here it won't be rotated, only this line, see here, this line is rotating like this, anti-clockwise is rotating. So from the rotation only we are getting, this way it may rotating, from the rotations of the data, it may rotating like this, like, grinder, it may rotate in the final, it gives the answer for us. That is called Verimax rotated things. The next is called direct quaternion rotated factor. So, what is the difference between these two? See here, it is there is a big gap, there is a big gap between the this line and this line. But in the case of this one, see here, the region's gap, the rotation also very narrow in nature, it may rotate like this, called direct quaternion rotated. Then this is called a factor flat rotated factor spaces, but normally we are using the Verimax. So don't, so if you are having the good theoretic input, you can do it. Otherwise, you can blindly you can go with Verimax. Verimax is here. Most of the research, they are adopting the Verimax only. Just I'm moving to the path. I'm directly moving to the SPSS analysis now. Yes. So I request you all to open the data sheet, which I'm sharing the morning, the first sheet. Please, I request to open the first sheet. factor analysis data set one. Factor analysis data set one, kindly open the data sheet. That is the SPSS file. Those are having the SPSS only, you can open it. Those are not having the SPSS in your laptop, you cannot able to open this file. Please, I request to those who are having the SPSS, you can try for open. Others, no need to be open because no need support. Even if you have the 16% 17%, that not at all issue, it may be opening if you have the SPSS in the sense. Because I've saved as the SPSS data, therefore it comes like this. Yes. Just is open. Kindly, those are open, kindly type in the chat box. Kindly type in the chat box. Harikumar, the morning I send one mail to all of you. There, the first sheet that is called factor analysis data set one. Factor analysis data set one. Okay. Yes. Nice. Okay. Now, kindly explore the data. Anyone can brief the data. So now with the variable view. It's only for SPSS. It's a SPSS data sheet. So anyone, whenever you find the data, the file exchange.sav, the file exchange.sav is called the SPSS file type, file extension, particularly the data set. If you go with the output, it may come as .spv. So there is a different format of the output as well as the data. So I'm sharing the data sheets only. Yes, kindly anyone can brief about the particular data, particular sheets which I'm sharing to you.
So there are 24 variables.
Yes.
Which containing age, gender, education, yeah. Occupation, mm. Marital status, income, family income, locality, work experience.
This is a background variable. Can we treat a background variable for applying the factor analysis? Is it needed? Is it needed to keep it? Consideration for the background variable? Anyone?
No, sir. No, sir.
No need. Therefore, we don't need up to the work experience. We are not taking consideration up to the work experience. We don't need any kind of background variable. We are going to check only the items. So here the items is called variables, right? How many variables are there? How many items we have? Can you tell? How many 15, items sir, are there?
15.
So kindly see the variable view. That's why I'm sharing as the Excel file because I already copy and paste it there. Otherwise, it takes much time to type the questions for exploring. What is the first variable? What is the first variable?
Share an affectionate
form
relationship with the child.
Yeah, please. I request you all. Normally, your screen is comes like this. Please, the label me comes like this. You have to explain the label. Then you can see the each statement. What is the first statement? I share an affectionate, warm relationship with the child. Let's see. We are going to check the relationship of the child to the parents. That is it. I'm going to measure it. That's why I'm giving the 50 statement to the parent. From the parent response, I'm going to be convert some kind of factors. So that is my idea. There's a 15 statement. Each 15 statement, we can treat it as a variable. Now, second statement, if upset, this child will seek comfort from me. This child and I always seems to trusting each other. There is a statement of 15, right? Can we do a factor analysis? Do you have any doubt in this? Now, kindly see the values. What is the scale we are using? Click the values option. What do you found from here?
Scale data, sir.
5 points.
It's a 5 point scale. That's good. Okay. Now these are the two things important. So we are checking this one. This is a statement. This is a values. Right. Now I'm going for the factor analysis. So what is the path? Anyone can tell what is the path? First, where you can go? Analyze. Right. So what is the main objectives of our what is the main objectives to reduce the
data reduction.
In the analyze, any terms related to the reduction or the
yes, data reduction is there.
Yeah, therefore this is a path. Now you can see what is the path? The path to reach the factor analysis, because our main objective is to do reduce the components in number of variable to the small variable we are going to compile, we are going to make it as a dimension based on the number of variables. Therefore, I'm going with the dimension reductions. There, I'm going with factor. I'm going with factor, pick the factor, pick this factor. Now you can see what are the options we are seeing from here. What are the options you are seeing from here? What is variable? Here, what is our variable?
Those 15 variables, I think.
Here we can pick, normally we are using the term as item, but here each item is nothing but our variable. Our variable is our item. Now I am insert all the 15 items except the background variable. Except the background variable. Yes. Can you move to the next level?
Yes, sir.
I already mentioned how many steps while going for the data factor analysis. What are steps? What is step number one?
Extraction.
See, I'm showing the step, then you can understand. What is the step number one? Yeah. What is the step number one?
Extraction.
See here. Therefore, what is first is comes? Extraction. So after extraction only where we can go? Rotations. Okay, so before the descriptive is that, descriptive is not only for descriptive, what is the need in the sense for checking the sample size, whether the sample size is adequacy or not. Therefore, we can pick the KMO. So before that, kindly anyone can check how many samples are there in our data sheet. Kindly see, anyone can see the data sets, how many samples are we have?
So how much sample is required?
300 is needed, but our data set, I'm talking about our data set.
30, sir.
Only 30. Therefore, kindly see whether 30. So 1 minute, I'm checking once. I forget this. Yeah. So how many data are there? Only 30. Therefore, sample, how much? What is our sample?
30 into 5 or what we have to do?
No, only 30. So we have the 30 only. So we have 30 samples. Normally the 30 sample is enough to run the factor analysis. Anyone can tell the answer?
No, sir.
It's not possible. But for the demo purpose only, I'm keeping the second example, it having matched. Okay. So because I want to show how the sample size adequacy, how we can check with this calling. That's why I'm going with this first example. I'm selecting all and clicking here. So in this case, the sample adequacy is not fair. Okay, so for checking the sample adequacy, what is the calculation we can go with the descriptives? You can go with KMO. This is a calculation for checking the sample adequacy. The KMO value is more than 0.5 is acceptable. More than 0.5, the KMO value is more than 0.5 is better. More than 0.6 instead of half, you can go with 0.6. Above the 0.6 value of the KMO value is acceptable. It means that the sample adequacy is enough. Then you can go for the remaining calculation. Then the parallel, you can see the PAT list. What is the PAT list is checking? This is sparsity. It's checking the whether your correlation, each items, each variable having the identical correlation. That is called the diagonal everywhere is one is coming. Whether the we are keeping like this. This is why I'm keeping one iPods also. See this iPods, then you may get it. This is why we have to keep it. What is the practice sparsity is talking about the measures of strength relationship among the variable. How the relationship between the variables with the use of PATLAS tester. Here, what is our hypothesis? Correlation matrix, identity matrix. So we are thinking that our matrix, we are going to find the identity matrix. Identity matrix means all the diagonals are 0, 1, and the above also very close to 0. That is our, it means called identity matrix. But we have to reject the null hypothesis, then only we can go further for the factor analysis. So our null hypothesis should be rejected in the case of Patty's test. So it means that if a significant value is less than 0.05 comes, we can adopt the, we can go for further for the factor analysis. Otherwise, you can go, don't go for the factor analysis. See this case, what is the significant value? What is the significant value? Can you see the significant value of the p-value? Sorry, the p-value. In this table, you can easily understand. So I'm taking
0.000.
So 000. So therefore, the nullify is accepted or rejected?
It's rejected, sir.
Is rejected. Therefore, we need to reject. Then only we can go further for the what is the fact analysis. Otherwise, you cannot go for the further fact analysis. Then same thing. The K-mode test is talking about the sample adequacy. If the score is more than 0.5, it's called barely accepted. It's minimum. 0.7 to 0.8 is acceptable. Above 9 is to be superb. So, but in the example, see this example. What is the Kaiser-Meyers test KMO? What is the score?
This 0.9.
That means that the sample size is more good. This is another example, not for this example, because I'm sharing only 30 samples. Therefore, damn sure it won't become 0.9. It may come below 0.4 only. We can check that also. Right? This is these are the two calculations we need for the descriptive. So for checking the two important things. Yes, I'm moving to the SPSS. Okay. Now, I hope now you understand now why we have to click the KMO for checking the sample adequacy, for checking the strength of the relationship. Then click continue. The descriptive over. The next is called extraction. In the extractions, I already mentioned the number of types of extractions. I already mentioned, just I'm opening the PPT, see the types which I'm showing to you. What is the types? Here it is the right. The types I'm showing to you. These are the types I already mentioned. What is the principal component analysis? Common factor analysis, image factoring, this much of there. Okay. The same thing it may comes here. See the SPSS. So if you click the principal, you are getting the maximum likelihood, then alpha factoring, image, then principal axis. But we are going to adopt the principal components only. Principal components. Then go with the discrete plot. Discrete plot, we can get some kind of diagram representation. From the diagram representation, we can understand how many factors may generating. How many factors may generating. Now, see this case extract. This is the things it's talking about, the confirmatory factor analysis, exploratory factor analysis. Anyone having the idea, if I take the based on eigenvalues, whether it's the confirmatory or the
exploratory.
Exactly, it's called exploratory. If I fix the factors, what it means? If you fix the factor, what it means?
Confirmatory.
Yes. So please, dear participants, kindly see there's two things we are going to check. We are going to do further whether we are going to confirmatory or the exploratory. Based on eigenvalue in the sense, we are fixing the one more than one. So when the variance is checking based on the variances come as the maximum to minimum. These are because we are fixing the principal component analysis. Once you fix the principal component analysis, the variances comes from the highest to the lowest. In this lowest eigenvalue, minimum one. Below the one, it won't be taken into consideration. Suppose I'm running the 15 statement. The variances, the first four variances, the scores is above one. It means that I have the four factors. So here we are fixing the eigenvalues greater than one represent. You don't have any theoretical background about your the particular variable having the number of components. That's why I'm going to based on eigenvalues. But I know I have some theoretical background. This particular variable having two components. Therefore, I'm fixing the two components here. Once you fix the two components, the results also may come with the two components only. Therefore, it's called confirmative. As the researcher, you know how many dimensions may generate in the sense, you can go with fixed factor based on the theoretical input. Suppose you don't know the theoretical input about the particular variable, you can go with the exploratory. So now, first time I'm going with the exploratory, for example, I'm going with the exploratory. Then click continue. Then second process over. So the descriptive over, extraction over. Okay. Now I move to the rotation. That is the second steps. I already mentioned what is the second step of the factor analysis. The factor analysis second step. What is the second step? Second step of factor analysis, factor rotations. In this factor rotations, we have the two method. What are the method? Orthogonal, oblique rotations. Okay. So this is there. I'm talking about the Varimax. Then this is called direct quartium. But we are going to adopt the Varimax only. I'm going with Varimax. Then here, lot of methods. You see here, QWERTY max, as well the Equo max and Proto max, but I'm going to vary max rotations. Then if you need your loading plat, you can go with the loading plat. Otherwise, you can remove it. Loading plat is not needed. We can only go with the rotated solutions. Then continue. Then second rotation is over. Then I move to the score spot. In this score spot, if you need to check the regressions values, you can go with the regressions. Otherwise, you can remove it. It's not compulsory to check this save as a variable, but I'm going with save as a variable and click continue. Then that is optional only. Then finally, I'm going to the options. In the options, short by size. What is a short by size? In the sense, it is based on the variances, maximum to minimum, it automatically short out. Suppose you don't need to be short out. It may comes like variable one, variable two, the same order you want to get, not from the variance order. You can remove this short by size, but you can suppress the value, because once you suppress the value, you may get some kind of clear output. Otherwise, everywhere you may find the number if you are not suppressing it, because if you are fixing the suppress default, it comes to 0.10. It means that 0.10 below the coefficients, it won't be shows here, but I like to go with up to 0.3. So it means that above the 0.3 value only, it's showing in the display. Below 0.3 value, it won't be showing as a display. Even though below the 0.3, you can remove the particular statement, because it's not having any factor, it's not generating any factor, the particular items or particular statement. Therefore, we are going with 0.3. Then click continue. So this much of things we have to do. I hope now you understand what are things I did. In the descriptive, I am selecting only the KMO for checking the sample size adequacy as well as the strengthening of the correlation. Then in the extraction, I am selecting the principal component. There I am selecting this unrotated factor, then screen plot. I am going with the what is that exploratory, because of the reason I am clicking the based. Then click continue. In the rotation, I am selecting the Varimax. Then in the scores, I am selecting the save variable. In the options, I am selecting the suppress the small and point. Click continue. Click OK. Kindly see how many of them got the response, how many of them got the output. Please, those who are reaching the output, kindly type in the chat box. Whoa, over a percent output you received. Yes, got very good. Saroj, Nithya, okay. Then Sandhya's okay. Priyan, Dashini, okay. Shwadi, okay. Very good. Now, the first table. What is the first table? What is the first table is showing to you? Descriptive.
KMO, sir.
KMO. So, what is the interpretation? What is the interpretation you are going to found from this? Whether
it's 0.4, so it's not adequate.
Yeah, so it means why is the sample adequacy comes 0.4 to 0 in this one? Because the sample is only near 30. Due to that only showing that it don't we go for the factor, and it's better we can go for maximum 300 sample, right? If you go with more than the 300 sample, damn sure it won't be goes more less than 0.5. It goes 0.7, 0.8. So in this case, the sample adequacy is totally is not fair. But what about the PATI test? Kindly see the PATI test.
It is significant, sir.
Significant. So for assumption also, we need to be significant. Therefore, not a total issue for doing further fact analysis. If here is not satisfying, no need to be see the fact analysis. You don't be adopt the fact analysis. You got clear? If the two cases not satisfied, you don't go for fact analysis. If you're doing the fact analysis, totally wrong. So what are the basic things to be satisfying? One is sample adequacy. Other one is called message the variables. Okay. So
if anyone is satisfying, what to do, sir? If anyone is satisfying, the other one is not satisfying, then, sir?
It's not possible. You have to be satisfied both, ma'am.
You have
to satisfy both. That is why you have to increase. You can increase the sample adequacy. Damn sure it may.
Essential to have 300 sample size?
Sorry?
Is it mandatory to have 300 sample size?
Yeah, it is mandatory, because a lot of theoretical input, that's why I'm showing one theoretical back. One person, I highlight the name, 1 minute. KMO result output. Yes.
Yeah. Sir, if sample size...
This is met by the Kaiser. So the same person is recommended. That you are talking about this one in a case of mail, no? So 0.5, 0.7, that is, he's given some kind of, what is that?
Sir, if sample size is
this is sample size, FIDEL 2005 says that general over 300 responses for sampling analysis probably adequate. There is a universal agreement the factor analysis is inappropriate when sample size below 50. You got clear? If you go, if you are increasing the sample size so fast, if you are less than 50, it's totally unfair. Okay, that is the thing it's said by the FIDEL.
Sir, if sample size is less than 300 and both these statements are satisfied,
then no problem. You can go. You can go with that. Is why they tell inappropriate for minimum 50 only. So if you're going, what is that, 100 or 200, it's not at all issue if you satisfy both the conditions. If you satisfy the criteria as well as the scarcity is satisfied, you can go further. Okay, but better you can go with the large sample. Okay, more than 300 should be safer job. Now, in this case, for example, I am assuming that both is satisfying. Therefore, I am seeing down. Because it's satisfying at least one, that's why I am going down. See this case. What is the extraction? So, here, what you found, the extractions, this is called the variances happen the factors. That the Burley test is talking about the, what is the strength relationship? Pradeshka, I already showed the display. See the table. I hope you are seeing this one. So in this case, Porteous test of sparsity should be significant. Should be significant. And that's why I'm showing this one. See this case, the correlation coefficient, normally the null hypothesis we are framed like this, but the null hypothesis should be rejected, should be rejected. Then only we can go further for the factor analysis. So that is the results I'm showing here. So I will share this PPT, then you can crack check later. Okay, then easy for you. Yes, so this is for the normal communalities things. The, normally the communalities describe the variance of each variable shared with other variable in research study. Normally the communality varies more than 0.5. So it should be 0.5 above. Kindly see any communalities vary less than 0.5. Kindly see it. The communality value, normally the communality is like describing the variance of the each variable shared with other variable in a research study. Communities value shows whether the variable or items are fit, unfit for the this kind of factor analysis. So if the score is less than 0.5, you could not go for the factor analysis for a particular statement. You have to remove the statement. For example, the first statement is less than 0.5. Therefore, avoid the particular statement. So you can go further with other statement only. So in this case, none of the statement is not less than 0.5. Therefore, you can go next level. You can go next level. Right. Now, this is another table. This is called eigenvalue. I already mentioned that what is an eigenvalue represent in the sense, it explains the proportion of variance described by the individual factor. It will be described like a proportions. It described by the individual factors, how the individual factors. Now see here. Initially, how many factors are there? See, there is an option, initial eigenvalues. How many components are there? See the components.
See the
15 components. It's nothing but our variable. So the initially is selecting the all the variables. But there is a extraction happen. It shows that the below one eigenvalue, we don't be consideration for the factor. Therefore, out of 15 items, how many items having
six.
More than one? Yeah, see here, that is why that below one is to be totally, what is that? Here is not that in the case of extraction sums. So you can look on the only the extraction sums. You have to look on the extraction sums. In the extraction sums, you are seeing the only the six factor. Therefore, your 15 statement, how many factors may come? You are going to convert the 15 six. Statement into?
Six statements.
Exactly correct. So six statement, okay? Now I'm coming down. So see this plot. What is that? The scatter plot. So the scree plot. It's not a scatter plot. It's called scree plot. In this, see the number of dots above the one. See the number of dots above the one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then 6. 1 and above. How many is there?
15.
Six. No. I'm talking about one. One above only. Don't go down there. Six. Therefore, how many factors?
Six.
You got clear? So you can cross check from here to here. Actually, this is an output only. This is a diagram. This is a table output only. This three plot. There you can check the one above. How many dots are there? That is called number of factors. So your 16 items may convert into six factors. Now I'm going to tell how these scores are coming. how the scores are coming. So you are telling that how the 2.946, how the 2.946 is coming. Anyone can tell the scores of, I'm going to open the Excel sheets. You can check, crack check whether the result is coming. Anyone kindly highlight the numbers. One thing, so what is the number? Yeah. So this is the number here, 10. What is the number? 0.833, 0.652, then 0.6434, 0.538, 0.359. These things you have to, only the first component. Anyone can tell the number, please? Anyone can tell the number? What is the first number? Anyone, please.
0.833.
What is the second one?
0.652.
What is the next one?
Then 0.634.
Next?
0.538.
Next?
Sorry. Minus 0.359.
Minus 0.3?
359.
359. Next?
0.704.
0.704. Next?
Sir, there are six columns. So shall I say only column?
Only this first column. Yeah. Okay, up to 0.490.
Okay.
Okay. What is it?
0.704, then 0.340.
0.340, yes.
0.490.
0.490, then?
Yeah. It means all, right, yeah.
Right. Now I'm going to tell how these things is coming. See here. This is like a correlation component matrix. So our 15 items is going to make, say, six factors. So the six factors coming. Okay, in the six factors. Hello.
Sir, will the negative has any significance? Because the
nothing. That's why I'm going to tell. So even the negative, if you're going for square, it automatically may change. I'm going to tell this how this value is coming, how the eigenvalues is coming. I'm going to tell that one only. See here. In this case, 0.83, the first component, it means that the items or 15 items having some kind of relationship between the factors. That's factor scores you are getting. That scores I'm typing here as a only first component. This is for the first component. For the first component, right? So there I'm going to be square it. I'm going to square the each one. So this is a square. What is a square? Point, just and square it. Yes, so 0.833 into 0.833, that's a square. So 0.69. So I'm squaring all. So I'm squaring all the first components. I'm going to summarize. I'm going to summary to add this sum. Okay. The sum of the whole. This one. Sorry. Let's see. Yeah. Sum of the whole column. Yes. Then enter it. Okay. So I got 2.79. So this is called our eigenvalue. See here, what is my eigenvalue? 2.790. Can you see the output? The eigenvalue? What is the output? Is it correct or not?
There is little change, sir. It is 2.790
They're making some kind of rounding. Because of the reason it comes like this. Other reason it comes like correctly. Okay. Due to the reasons of the fractions. Okay. Now the next thing. See here, there is a variance 19.642. So we have 2.94. I'm typing the same score here. 2.94. What is the variance percentage? I'm going to tell this how the variance percentage is coming. So now you understand how the component scores are coming. Now I'm going to tell how this variance percentage is coming. So now we know the first component, the total extractions, it comes the 2.946. After 2.946, I'm going to divide by number of statements. We have 15 statements. Therefore, divide by 15. Therefore, I'm going to divide the answers. So is equal to this divided by this one. Okay, 15. So 0.1964 into 100, because we are going to convert into 100, no? Therefore, I'm going to convert as a percentage, is equal to this into 100. So 19.64. Can you see the percentage there? Is it correct? Is it correct?
Yes.
Now you are clear how it these things is coming. So how did this thing is coming? This is from the component. Suppose if you are adding this each component, the first component 0.833 whole square plus 0.652 whole square. If you are adding all, you may get this answer. Okay, you may get this answer. 2.946. You divide by the 15 into 100, you are getting this option. The same way, if you are count, anyone can kindly count this one, kindly square it, 0.419 square plus 0.451 square plus 0.73 square plus 0.35 square plus 0.506 square plus 0.427 square. If you are squaring and adding, you are getting this answer. What is the answer? 2.035. So this is way the eigenvalue is coming. For explaining, I am using this one, but while using the space disorder, logic is not needed, but I am explaining how this results coming. For the reason I am telling, from the component matrix only, that above the eigenvalue is coming. Now, I am coming down. This is our final table. There we are going to compile it. Anyone can type in the chat box. Anyone can, you can type the chat box, which I'm going to tell, no, that you can type. See this case, factor one, we have the six factor. What is the factor one? This number, the factor one, which are the items to be lying the factor one in this sense. See this case, what is the factor one? What is the maximum score is lying the factor one, whether in the first component or the fifth component. So the first items or first variable, it may goes with first component for the second. But where is lies? Maximum score, where it is? Maximum score. Maximum score. Jay Shadi is correct. Okay, exactly one. So what about the second item? What about the second item? No, Pradishka, each go with each item wise. Pradishka, go with each item wise. First item. What is my first item? V1. So V1 call, we can see the first row, there is a two scores coming, 0.776, 0.317. It means the first items may go with the first comment or the fifth comment. But out of this, we have to check only the where the high score is coming. Therefore, the high scores may come in the first comment. Therefore, the first quadrant, the first questions may lie on the where, which factor? First, very good. What about the second one? What about the second item? What about the second item? What about the second item? What about the third item?
First factor.
First factor, very good. Fourth item?
Fourth factor.
Yeah, we have the four factors. See here, the fourth question may go with the four factors, but which of the things so high? Only the fourth factor. Therefore, the fourth question, keep it as a fourth component. You got clear? The fourth question, you can keep it as a fourth component. What about the fifth question?
Fourth factor.
Okay. What about sixth question?
Third factor.
Third. Why you are not going to the minus? So if you're having the minus, it may less. Okay. So don't go with the negative symbol. You can check the what is the positive, which is the best one. Okay. So therefore, may lies on the third. What about seventh item?
Second factor.
Eighth item?
Sixth.
What about the ninth item?
Second.
What about the 10th item?
First one.
What about the 11th item?
Fifth.
12th item?
One.
Very good. 13th item?
Two.
Second.
Very good. 14th item?
Third.
15th item also third. But I feel that already we have the 15th statement. Why I can go with 6? Okay. So because we are running whether it's a confirmative factor analysis or exploratory factor analysis. Which I did now?
Exploratory.
So now you understand that how these scores are dividing. Now I'm going with the confirmative. For example, the same data, I'm going with the confirmative. So I'm going with analyze. I'm going with where we can go, dimension reduction factor. So descriptive, we already clicked the KMO. I'm going with the extraction. So kindly anyone can brief which one I have to tell, which one I have to click for the confirmatory factor analysis?
Fixed number of factors.
Okay. So I feel that there is a theoretical background about the relationship between the father and child. It's talking about the four quadrant, so four component. That's why I'm typing here four. So I'm making this a four. Click continue, click OK. Now see the output. See the output. Whether the case is not satisfying. Why the case is not satisfying? Because the logic, our sample is
the sample.
Yeah, because we had to use the large sample. In this case, it's not satisfying. What about the fattest test? It's significant. Therefore, we can go for further analysis. So I'm coming down. See this case. Previously, six times comes. Now see here how many terms are coming. How many eigenvalues coming? See,
four.
Why is coming only four?
You're given four factors, sir.
Yeah, exactly. So if the four factors, only the four factors eigenvalues only coming in this case. Then I'm coming down. See the screed plot. Even the screed plot is showing six, but we are going to consider only four. Now this is a component matrix analysis. Now how these scores 2.946 is how it's coming. This is based on the square of the each component and divided by. Square and add, you may get that number. So this he knows. Then we have to look on the rotated component matrix. Anyone can type in the chat box, which are the items may lies on the first factors. You can type as a first factor and number. This is an output. There's a four factors. Kindly give the numbers. Please kindly give the numbers. The factor one, which are the items may lies? The factor one. Then other people can type factor two. You can go with all, madam, Trivathi, you can type all the factor one. So I'm talking about the first component, which are the items may lies. You can go with first factor, the item number one, item three, item five, like you can type. Yeah, so kindly see the item, you can go with factor one. The first factor, what are the questions may lies? Then factor two, what are the items may lies? Yes, Sanjina has given. So yes, kindly check properly. Factor one. Anyone can summarize all. First factor, what? Second factor, third factor, fourth factor. Then we can assign the number also. Then we can give the name also for this factor. Okay. Kindly see. Yeah, see here. This is called first item, which lies on the first factor. Second item also first factor. Third item, it should be third factor. Fourth item, first factor. Then fifth item, first factor. Then sixth item. Fourth factor. Then seventh item is the second factor. What about the eighth item? Can we take in consideration eighth item? Anyone can have
it. It's negative.
Better to be omit that item. Okay. Better to be omit the item. Okay. If it comes a negative, then the child, the ninth item comes to second. Then 10th item comes to the first. The 11th item comes to the third. Then 12th item comes to the first. 13th item comes to the 14th item comes to the 4th, 15th item comes to the 4th. Okay. Now I'm going to give the name. Suppose you are giving the factor 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 10. I'm going to read the statement. You have to give the number, give the name for this. Please, I request all give the names, unique factor name. The questions you have to read, the question number 1, because the factor 1 is like question number 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, what are the... 1, 2, factor 1, anyone can brief, 1, 2, 4, 5, 10. Okay. Kindly read the statement of 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and give some.
Three is there also. 1, 2, 3, 4, 10.
Three also. Yeah, yeah. Not three. Three slice on the third.
Three is
note.
Third.
I mean,
no, sir. Three, sir.
Even 12, no? So please kindly kindly type one person, write in the factor one only. Please, anyone can type the entire factor lies on the first factor.
I've written it, sir, already.
So once I can copy and paste, because I'm not able to see the order. Okay, please, anyone can just copy and see. Pradishka, is automatically, I'm already told it's a Varimax rotations. It's Varimax rotations rotating. From the rotation, the components come. The first, see these two comparisons. There is a two numbers you are getting from the first item. you can see the witches and maximum scores in the first items. It lies on the first component. Therefore, we can keep the first item as the first component. You got clear?
Sir, I have posted, sir.
Yeah, yes, thank you, Kanyana. So, first, second, kindly read the statement and coin some general name for this. So, for example, I share an affectionate, warm and relationship with the child, first item. The second item, if I upset, the child will seek comfort from me. Okay. Then fourth items, this child values his relationship with me. Okay. The fifth items, the child spontaneously shares information about himself or herself. Okay. Then fifth items, okay. Tenth item, what is this child is comfortable in sharing information with me. Okay. Then 12th items, the child is openly shares. Yeah. So here, then Praveen sir is giving say correct term comfort zone. Instead of the comfort zone, can we use the term intimacy? Can we use the term intimacy? Intimacy, so like a bonding. So therefore, the first factor, I'm calling the name as say intimacy. So it's okay now. So the first factor, I am giving as a name as say intimacy. This is called factor generating. So I feel that the intimacy word is correct. Yeah, intimacy. So cordiality. So you can define, as a researcher, you can define based on the items which is come to the factor. So, but I like, you can go with intimacy, okay? Now, I'm going to second factor. Anyone can type the second factor? Second factors, numbers, can you type the second factor number? Which are the questions, items may lies on the second factor? Yeah, so item number 7. Item number 7, 9:30, which is 7. When I praise this child, he, she beams with pride, okay? Then item number 9 is talking about the child feels happy with my presence. Okay. Then another one is called last is 13. What is the 13 item? So everything is talking about the happiness only. So the child easily becomes active in my presence. So it's like a motivation, no? Because it's like the children's getting motivation once you are near to them. So can you use the term as a motivation? Some people are putting sharing and caring. Better the single word, praiseworthiness, is better than motivation. Motivation, I feel the motivation things should be more apt for this. That's why I'm using motivation. You can use the other term, okay? And there is not at all issue, Praveen Kumar sir, it's not at all issue. At least 3 or 4 statement may lies in this. If you have the 15 items, at least 3 or 4 is lies, you know, this is good. Yeah, I'm using the term as a motivation. Is it okay? Then anyone can create a third factor name. Anyone can create a third factor name. So what are the factors? What are the items that comes to the third factor? Kindly type the number. So the item number 3. So kindly read item number 3. The child and I always seems to be trusting each other. Okay. Okay. Then what
Excuse
is that?
Me, sir.
Yes, yes.
Each number item means negative value is there. So shall we take that?
No, you can remove that. You can remove that. If you are finding the only that negative values comes, you can remove that item. So you don't be consideration for the 8th items for the compilation. Okay. Yeah, exactly. Devapriya is correct. We can use the term trustworthy. Trust. It's a good, it's a term. Trust is correct. Okay. So the first, what is my first factor? Intimacy. Second factor, motivation. Third factor, trust. Very good. What is the third factor? Fourth factor? Anyone can tell? Third, fourth factor? Yeah, exactly. So what are the items in the fourth factor? 6, 14, 15. Very good. So we can use the term dependability. What are the items is talking very easy. The child reaches me to get suggestion for the problem case. It's like a problem solving based is to be discussing. We see the next statement, 14th statement. The child always having the interest to get my then 15th time, the child comes me selecting the right choice for decision. Yeah, it's like a problem based is coming. It's better problem solving as a dimension. Okay, otherwise dependency. So it's an investigation. So I feel the problem solving somewhat because the two statement is related to the problem solving. Therefore, I am going with problem solving. This is my predictions. I am doing like this. So you can go with your things. Decision making. Yeah, exactly. Decision making also is a correct term. Decision making. So I hope now you're clear, no? How we can do the factor analysis. So based on the component, you have to decide. You can read the statement. You can coin these things. Okay. So therefore, I am keeping that the first component name. What is the first component name? Intimacy. Second component name?
Motivation.
Motivation. What's the third component? Trust and problem solving. You got clear? Just I'm going to be run the next data. So I'm going to close this one because we already reached 12:51. Yeah. So can we go with one more data I'm sharing to you? Kindly open the second data set which I'm sharing to you. Can it take five more minutes?
Yes, sir.
Okay, please go with factor analysis data set two.
Sir, can we not do this for achievement test? Because you said for continuous variable it is not suitable. But if I want to do factor analysis of knowledge understanding kind on my achievement test.
Exactly, you said is correct. That's why achievement test we cannot do it, because achievement test we are already make it like a blueprint. No? The blueprint based only you are developing here achievement test, right? And also in the achievement test we are looking on the knowledge understanding application, that domains only. So therefore no need to be go for the achievement test, is not be asked for this kind of calculations, right? Okay, so now I hope you all are open. No, you open the second set. How many statement?
Yes, sir.
12 questions.
How many samples? 100, sir. Okay. Can you see the variable view and see the questions? You are able to see the question? Go with the labels.
Yes, sir.
So the friendly classmates available. It's talking about, so there is a spelling mistakes. So like the classroom environment is accessing. Can we fix the confirmative now? Can we go with the confirmative?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
I'm going to analyze. So now anyone can tell the path. Where we can go?
Analyze.
Then?
Dimension.
Dimension reduction.
Then?
Factor.
Then?
Then take all the items to the variables.
Okay. Variable.
Then go to descriptive.
Go with the descriptive. Yes, okay.
Descriptive. Yeah, that is KMO test. Continue. Extraction. Go with fixed number of factors.
Fixed number of factors. Yeah.
Factors to extract.
Yeah.
Like
how many? Yeah, that's okay. So fixed. Okay, so can we go with the three factors?
Yes, sir.
Can go with three factors.
Yes, okay. Sir.
Continue. Then.
Then continue. Then I did not give them
rotation. Much. Rotation.
Rotation very max.
Very max.
Very max. Okay. Very max. Continue. Then
scores.
They need to be no need. I'm removing this score.
Yeah. Not required. Option also like. If you want to sort
of
small question.
Yeah. So see here, I'm not suppressing anything. I'm not suppressing anything. What the result is coming, see here. Okay. Just I'm going to continue. See what it happened. Now what about the KMO test? KMO test satisfying or not? KMO test satisfying?
Satisfying.
Yes, sir.
Satisfying. Right. Well, what about the Patty's test satisfying?
It is significant.
Right. Very good. So now the communality, see the communality. Whether communality is satisfying? Communality property?
Community property is 0.5
above. So here some of the items is less. Okay. So
because we are not suppressed, we are getting this
thing. Oh, that is right. So it comes like this. Anyway, I'm seeing this one. See these down. How many components are coming? How many components to the extraction?
Three components.
Now. Now you can come for the rotation components. See here, lot of numbers are there. Rotated component matrix, lot of numbers are there. For eliminating lot of numbers, what I'm going to do, see here. Previously what we did, so I'm going to dimension reductions. I'm going to factors. In the options, we are not suppressing. That is why a lot of numbers are coming. I'm going to suppress less than 0.3, I don't need. I'm suppressing this one. I click continue. Click rotate. And see the results. See the results of last one.
Yes, sir.
You got the report?
Yes, sir.
Yes, now kindly tell what about the first item? Very close.
Second items.
First factor.
Third item, fourth item, fifth item, sixth item, first factor, seventh item, third item, third factor, eighth item, first factor, ninth item, last factor, third factor, tenth item, second, eleventh item, twelfth item, fourteenth. So I hope now you are getting clarity. You can coin the names. Okay, fine. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. So I'm giving you two more tables. Yes, yes, ma'am.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah. Please.
Sir, while giving names, we can give the names according to our logic, right, sir?
Yeah, our logic. If you have some theoretical backgrounds, for example, we are putting the confirmative fact analysis. Got clear? If you fix the confirmative fact analysis, we can follow some kind of theoretical background. They already given some kind of domain names. That domain name, you can use it based on the factor. You got clear? The same name, you can use it if possible. Or else you can do some modification in the term. Okay.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, ma'am. Please.
Sir, in factor analysis, when we clicked on factor analysis, there are variables are there. We have selected that, no doubt. But what is selection variable? Selection variable one table is there, sir.
Where it is, ma'am?
Analyze, then dimension reduction, then factor analysis. Yeah, factor. Yeah, that is selection variable is there.
Sorry, I'm not exposing that one. Still, I'm not exploring this one. So once I explore, I will tell you, because without only I'm not telling. So okay, thank you.
Sir, one more doubt.
Yeah.
Sir, when you're subtracting the quotient values, the absolute value below, on which basis we will give the values? Is it up to us or?
Your voice is cracking. Yeah, that's better. Rajkumar, your question in the achievement test, the difficulty level discipline. That is for the item analysis, no? So that is for the item analysis. Item analysis differ, factor analysis will be differ. Okay, item analysis, you are going to check whether you are going to retain your statement or delete the statement. Further, we are doing that kind of item analysis techniques. Even the papers are using for the other scales and all, they're using the what is the Cronbach alpha value calculation, or with the even some people are using a test that is the item with item total correlation. Lot of technique they are adapting for doing item analysis. Yes. So when we are subjecting the coefficient, the absolute value is based on any theory. No. It's automatically it's running by the so the absolute value based on what is that absolute value you are talking? The suppressing the coefficient. The context of the eigenvalue or where, Zainab?
Like we did both ways now, without suppressing and with suppressing.
Yeah. Based on the eigen is better. If you don't have any theoretical background, you can go for the eigenvalue based, like exploratory. Okay, there is you could not be decided from the decision side. If you have a theoretical background, you can suppress the coefficient. Okay, you can fix the coefficient. Okay.
Okay.
That is why Rajvind, how do you decide the fixed number of factors? That is why, listen, Rajvind Karor, if you go with confirmative factor analysis, we need some theoretical background. Suppose I am developing a tool related to the environment, classroom environment. There is a lot of theoretical background is telling that the classroom talking about the room's atmosphere, then teachers, influences, like the three components I found from some kind of theoretical background. Therefore, I am fixing the three components. That is for confirmative factor analysis. For this, the theoretical background is needed. From the theoretical background, you are finding that the three, you are going to fix the three. But if you go with exploratory factor analysis, no need to worry about the number of factors. It's based on the eigenvalues when it comes to eigenvalues. Okay. Yes.
Sir, can you please provide once again the link of SPSS cracked version? I'm facing problem with it. I'm not able to find that in Google Classroom.
The Google Classroom I removed. Okay, I will share spaces separately through mail. Okay.
Okay.
Kindly, actually, yours mail ID is something Lily's. I'm getting some mail. What is your mail ID? I already shared one link. I kindly check your mail.
Sir, devapriya.goshnine.
You can type in the chat box. Otherwise, you can send one PP one mail to me. Just remind me. Okay,
sir.
So Trivedi, what is the question for this? Can we use factor? What is this? What is the question?
Sir, when I teach chemistry and the students have to answer questions on say isomerism. So isomerism needs that the child has special ability, numerical special ability, and conceptual ability.
Yeah. Then you can go for.
The score is continuous in achievement. Will that be okay? Like I have an objective question.
So the objective question yes or no type or 0-1 pattern.
They have to select yes or no, like, yeah.
Yes or no, it's not fair. Okay.
Not yes or no, but it's an actually the it's visuals are given
and just that. It's like a character wrong. It's like a character wrong, or you are going to say.
Yeah.
It's not be fair then. Okay.
Like I want to establish that how many.
Listen. You already have the theoretical knowledge because he knows the visual numerical concept understanding. So when you're developing the tool itself, you can divide the components. Like when you go for achievement test, no. What we are doing the achievement test. First, we are developing a blueprint. From the blueprint only, we are developing an achievement test. The same manner, you can go for, you know already the dimensions. Then the dimension, you can generate, you can create a questions. So if you don't have the dimensions, only, you
can go. What kind of ability allows the child to learn which kind of a concept?
Sorry?
So there are some students who are good at, say, physical chemistry or mole concept, and some are good at organic chemistry with, they need some visual spatial ability. So to establish that, we will have to use that. Can we use factor analysis here, Vitsal?
Yeah, of course. For the, that, what is that? That point you said, no, there it may be apt. Okay, it may be apt. So once I know the data type, because we, whenever you do any analysis, we must think about the data types, whether it's a nominal, ordinal, interval, it where it lies, whether any theoretical background is that, everything we have to look on, then only we have to apply any statistical techniques. We cannot be blind, accept all things. Okay, so because that's why I'm telling this kind of argument. You can cross check the assumptions. If the assumptions are satisfying for your data, you can go further. Okay,